Hey, so I can't tell what's going on. Are we live? Hey, all right. So I guess I am live. And I'm going to continue here. All right, here we go. So I don't have a fancy countdown or anything, so I'm just going to go right into it. Hi, I'm David, and I am making a costume for my daughter for Halloween. She wants to be a moth. And I need to turn that down. Sorry, getting a little feedback from my computer here. Turn that down. All right. So this is real professional, I know, but anyway, I was saying I'm making a this cape. My daughter found this pattern on Etsy, so she wanted to be a moth. So I said, yeah, I can make that. Where I'm at now is I've made the parts of the wings. I just stitched this and turned it around, stitched the backing on and turned it inside out. I have one more of these to do and then two of the front wings to do. And I have to attach them all together and I have to make a collar out of fur. And the other thing I'm going to do, which I don't have the parts for yet, is I'm making a little like antennas for her. So that's funny. All right, so I have this pinned in place. So this is the front panel. That's interesting. Inside out, so I have the backing. And I'm going to stitch this with a 5/8 inch seam allowance. And to do that, sorry, a little distracted here. Just to make sure I'm right, I got this nifty little thread. It says seam ruler. And the way this works is depending on which way you want to see your how deep your thread is going to be, all you have to do is line up that with where your needle plunges down, and then you have you can see where it lines up with the lines on. I'll bring this a little closer. So this lines up with the marks on my sewing machine plate here as well. Let me go back to that. I'm using just a straight stitch for this. That's not good. Bring that up. And I'm just going to stitch all the way around this. I'm leaving this top open because I need to be able to. I can't see what I'm looking at here. I'm leaving this top part open so that I can turn it inside out. You pull your pins out because you don't want to sew over your pins. That would be bad. How long is my stitch length? That's a little tight. That's really short. Notice this starts to bunch up a little on me. All right, let's go back to my overhead. So now I'm going to clip all these edges so that when I turn my wing back right side out, it won't bunch up. If I can only figure out where I left my clips. My snips. There we go, snips. Be careful not to cut into your. Well, gotta be careful not to cut myself or my thread line. All right. I'm going to turn this right side out. Yeah, hopefully these are the same size and shape. Oh, I forgot to take a pin out. That's why that's not opening up. All right, so I gotta press that down as well. Is there another pin in here? Yep. Forgot to pull my pins. So I'm just getting started with this live streaming stuff. I always feel like I sound like I'm out of breath when I do this. Mostly because I'm concentrating, I guess. I started a Facebook page, spooling around in a group. If you're watching this in the replay, I should probably put the links in the description. But I didn't do any of that ahead of time. That camera, that's the other thing I'm working on, is changing my camera angles so that everything works. But these look pretty good. So these will join together like that. That's looking pretty moth-like, I think. Where's my camera? I'll pull back this way. Yeah, so once I press this, I'm going to do a top stitch, and then I can join the whole thing together. Still learning where my cameras are. Check something. I always forget to turn off. Low light compensation, because we do not have low light. And let's fix the exposure a little bit. That looks better. Now we're ready for prime time. All right. Let's put Mr. Skull somewhere. Reach him more easily. And my bobbin ran out. Okay. So on this machine, it's actually super easy to change out. Because I'm spastic. This sewing machine is kind of my unicorn. I always look in thrift stores for stuff, and I saw this and snagged it for $30. I don't know who gave it up or why, but it runs great. It's a electronic machine, which I've never owned an electronic machine before, so this is new. I had to find the It's about probably about 7 or 8 years old, if I had to guess. I've never owned an electronic machine, so it does a whole bunch of stitches and stuff that I didn't know that I needed before. So I'm excited to figure out what else I can do with this. All right. Wind the bobbin here. And it came off the little... It's supposed to stay wrapped around this little tension disc. It popped out. I just hope it doesn't get too knotted up in there. And it stops automatically. This is also one of the easiest to thread machines I've ever had. Again, like I said, this is modern. The newest machine I had before was maybe 20 years old. But it was a mechanical. And it's not a drop and bobbin, it's a front loading. So it's a neat thing. So like to thread the bobbin, it's literally drop it in and run it through these little hooks, run it around, and then it cuts off there. And then to thread the machine, what's weird about this machine is it doesn't have a take-up arm like a lot of other machines. So it just has this one groove you drop your thread in and give it a little tug. And it even has an automatic needle threader, which works better than the other ones I had. And that's it. You're ready to sew. So, kind of impressed. Start where we were. Gonna do a little backstitch. Also, the backstitch. Let's see. Just hold that little button, and I'm not even pressing the foot pedal when I do that. Which also, if you're used to an electronic machine, you're probably used to that. I've never experienced that before. So. Let's go. Getting a little bunched up here. Don't jump up on me. Don't be suspicious. Come on, flatten out a little there. Thank you. Not looking bad. Gonna trim off all this. I'm gonna have a lot of excess on this end, but I'm gonna trim all that off. Nope, that's the shot I want. So as I get better at doing these live streams, I'll probably have music, maybe a little graphics, and an audience. That would be nice. I'm gonna turn this inside out as well. Oops. Make sure I'm in between the right layers. That's what we want. All right. For this, I will try another little tool that I got. Oh, that's unfortunate. One of my appliques has gone astray. I'm gonna have to fix that somehow. Keep messing that up. Here we go. So this is front wing. And you can see right here, it started to separate a little bit. This is a Halloween costume, so I'm not sure how much I'm going to care. Halloween's in a couple of days. So the kid kind of gets what the kid gets. I'm getting... There's another little gizmo that I got. It's called the Magic Finger. It's from, got this from Madame So. Not sponsored, but I bought a lot of little gizmos from them. Little, I'll give them a quick review. Very good customer service. They have a lot of sales. Kind of constantly promoting stuff, so you always keep an eye on their prices. But they have little gadgets and feet and other little things. I don't know. I'm not doing a very good job of promoting them. But I got this little, it's like a little finger. It's good for pulling threads too, but it kind of get into your seams and just really push them out. Arm up in here. Well, right through the seam. That's not good. All right. Again, I have to press this down and top stitch it. You can't see what I'm doing, can you? Again, I always get that wrong. All right. I gotta wrestle this a little bit to get it to lay flat, I think. And that is half of the eye mark on the Emperor Moth wing. So, getting there. Now, here's a funny story. I was doing a live on Facebook, and I had a close-up of this with my hand like that, and I got flagged for inappropriate sexual content because Facebook thought it was a boob, I guess. So They took my, and I had to contest it, and they put my video back up, but it was kind of funny, actually. Anyway, I got one more of these to do, and then I gotta press everything top stitch and then put the whole thing together. But I'm gonna sign off for now because it has been about a half hour. So it was a good dry run for doing live streams here on YouTube. If you happen to watch this, let me know in the comments. I will be trying to do these more often and better, I hope. So you can, I don't have a schedule yet. I don't know when I'll be doing these frequently. I will be doing a live on another friend's channel, Lala, who's the mommy guide, craft guide. Again, not prepared for this, but my friend, we're going to be doing a live stream with my friend in November. So it'll be fun, and I'll be better prepared for it, I promise. All right. I'm going to sign off for now.